Good morning, everyone. My name is Amit Kumar Singh, and welcome to the next session on simple interest and compound interest. So I believe you have gone through my first session on simple interest and compound interest. So in that session, I basically explained the difference between simple interest and compound interest. We try to understand this topic probably in the end of in the economics point of view. So what this topic is all about. So more beyond probably discussing the same thing in the context of what you can say in the context of quantitative aptitude, I try to talk on something which is related to economics, something which is the part and parcel of our life. So beyond mathematics, we need to go and try to correlate the same scenario in what is happening around us and how that is going to affect us. So when we talk about simple interest and compound interest, it basically works on a formula that amount is equal to principal plus interest. It basically works on this formula that amount is equal to principal plus interest. So when we work on this formula that amount is equal to principal plus interest, in accordance with that formula, the money what you put for investment, that is called as the principal, and the value what you got on that money, that is what we call as interest, and the sum total of the value what you get at the end of your maturity, probably when you want to expire your instrument, then the value what you get back, that is called as amount. When we talk about interest, interest as a factor, we calculate interest by two ways. Either we can calculate interest by following simple interest methodology, or we can calculate interest by working on compound interest methodology. Simple interest methodology does not follow time value of money. In the case of simple interest, your principal remains constant, so you get the constant interest after every regular interval. While when we talk about compound interest, in the case of compound interest, you get interest on interest. So already I have discussed these concepts. I talked about the formula of simple interest and compound interest also. So now focusing, just let do revision of that formula. So the interest, when we talk about the interest, in the case of simple interest, the formula is P into R into T by 100. Or I can write that the same formula as P into R percent into T. Well, the amount in the case of simple interest, that is equal to P plus P into R into T by 100. So if I take P common, then the amount is equal to 1 plus P into 1 plus RT by 100. So with this way, you can calculate the amount. Then when we talk about amount in the case of compound interest, so when I follow compound interest, in the case of compound interest, the amount is equal to P into 1 plus R by 100 to the power T. While the interest, what we can calculate from compound interest, so that can be calculated by the formula, that is P into 1 plus R by 100 to the power T minus 1. So with this, we can calculate the interest through compound interest. So all this we know, and we can already discuss a lot understanding the concept of simple interest and compound interest. All these are important for us to work on. So going further, if we talk about numerical and all, so in the first session already I've done question number 1 and question number 2. Now if I talk about question number 3 here, so the population of a town grows at the rate of 20% every 5 years. So in how many years will it get double itself? So let the population in the beginning is 100. So the population grows at 20%. So after 5 years, this will become 120. After 5 years, this will become 120. Then again, after 5 years, it will become 144. I hope you can easily understand. No need for you to calculate anything. Again, after 5 years, it will become 144. Then again, after 5 years, so you know that this would be 172.8. So again, after 5 years, this would be 172.8. So So means if I talk about cumulative, this is after 5 years, this is after 10 years, this is after 15 years. You can easily understand this. 20% is nothing but double of 10%. So if I talk about 120, the 10% of 120 is 12. So while the 20% of 120 would be 24, 120 plus 24, it would become 144. Then 144, if I talk about 10% of 144 is 14.4, while the 20% of 144 would be 28.8. So 144 plus 28.8, that will give you 172.8. I'm doing it in the other way because I know 12 square is 144, 12 cube is 1728. So like that way I'm correlating it. So you can understand this. Now so this is after 15 years. Now it becomes 172.8. What they're asking you in this problem? So they're asking you in this problem that after how many years will it get double itself? After how many years will it get double? So again, if you increase this by 20%, so then the 10% of this would be 17.28. So the 20% would be 34.56. So if you add 172.8 with 34.56, so how much you get? You will get 207.36. So this will happen after 20 years. After 20 years, this will reach 207.36. This is what I was looking for. I was looking for when it get double. So when 100 become 200, so that is happening somewhere close to 20 years, not exactly 20 years, but before 20 years. So because I don't have scientific calculator and other tools or log table, so approximately I'll say this is happening after 20 years. Fine. So you can do it very easily. You don't need formula and all to get the answer for these kind of questions. Similarly, you can see this question number 4. Finally, you can see question number 4. The amount on a certain principal for 3 years and 4 years at certain rate of compound interest are this. So what is the rate of interest? Suppose this is the question. So the amount on certain principal for 3 years and 4 years. So your amount after 3 years, is that I can write as 3 into 1 plus r by 100 to the power 3. That is 18250.5. While your amount after 4 years is 3 into 1 plus r by 100 to the power 4, that is equal to 20988.1. So what is the rate of interest? So in order to find the rate of interest, divide the equation 1 from equation 2. So you can find the rate of interest 3 into 1 plus r by 100 to the power 4 divided by 3 into 1 plus r by 100 to the power 3 is equal to 20988.1 divided by 18250.5. So if you divide this, the equation 1 from equation 2, what you will understand? You will understand this is as 1 plus r by 100 is equal to 20988.1 divided by 182505. So I can write this as r by 100 is equal to 09881. Then this is 182505. So this will be minus 1. So I can find this value. This is 209881. This is 182505. This is 6. This is 7. This is 3. Then this is 7. Then this is 2. So you will get this 6 plus 5, 11, 11, 8, then 8, then 9, then 10. So you got this. So R by 100. So the value of R is 273760 divided by 182505. So I can cancel this. So this is 5, 4, then 7, then 5, then 2, then 0. This would be 3, then 6, 5, 0, 1. So now this is 9, 10, 15. This is 9, this is 15, this would be 12 plus 9, 12, 14, 14 plus 9, 23. It won't be divisible. So what I can do, 5, 4, 7, 5, 2, 0. This is 3, 6, 5, 0, 1. This will go 1ja because 2ja will start with 6. So this would be 3, 6, 5, 0, 1. This is 1, 5, 2, then this is 8, 1, 0, then 3, 6, 5, 0, 1, then 6, this is 30, 39, carry, this will be bigger than that, so it will go by 5, it will go by 5, 15 point something, so no need to solve it, 15 point something will be. So you can see the option 17, anyway 17 can't be the thing. This answer would be around 15 point something. It's fine. You can see the options and no need of solving it further. So the R value would be 15 point something. Fine. You can understand this. So compound interest, simple interest question will not be difficult. You can solve it very easily. So not require very specified mathematical techniques to solve those questions. Now let's try to understand the other question. Now you can see this question. Mr. Thomas invested with amount of 13,900, which is divided into two different schemes A and B at the simple interest of 14% and 11%, and the total amount of simple interest earned in 2 years after 2 years is this much. What is the amount invested in B? So they're asking you about B. So total is 13,900. So suppose this is A, so A I can write 13,900 minus B, while this is B because they're asking about B. So the rate of interest here is 14% for 2 years. So for 2 years, 14% would be how much? 0.28, 14 2za, that would be 13,900 minus B. This is 11%. For 2 years, so that would be 0.22b. The sum total of the interest is 3508. So just very simple, I just need to calculate. 0.28 into 13,900 minus b plus 0.22b, that is equal to 3508. I need to solve this. So this, if you want to solve this, this is nothing but 139 into 28. 9 is the 72, 24 plus 7, 20, 31, 3 carry, 11. Then this is 18, 1 carry, 7. This is 2, 9, 8. So this is 3, 8, 9, 2. You can do this calculation. 139 into 28, you can do that calculation. Fine. So 139 into 28. So 1 minute. So I can check with calculator the same value. 28 into 139. That is 3892. So this is 3892 minus 0.28b plus 0.22b equal to 3508. So this is 3892 minus 508. This would be 0.06b. So this is 3508. This is 4, this is 8, this is 3, 384 is 6 by 100 into B, this is 64. So the value of B, it is 6400. So the value of B is 6400. What is the amount invested in the scheme B? So in A and B, so what is the amount invested in scheme B? So Mr. Thomas at 13,900, he divided into two scheme A and B at the rate of 14%. At A at 14% and B at 11%, then this, what is the amount invested in scheme B? That is coming around 6400. 6400 is there in option. This would be answer 640. And now going further, you can see the next question. Then simple interest on certain sum of money at the rate of 4% for 5 years is 1680. At what rate of interest the same amount will be received after 4 years? So the next question is simple interest on certain sum of money at the rate of 4% per annum for 5 years is 1680. So you can solve it. So that is 1680 simple interest. That is T into R into T by 100. So this, with this you can find the principal. Principal would be 8400. Okay, so at what rate of interest the same amount received after 4 years? So you want the same amount, you want 1680, but you want this at after 4 years. So what rate of interest that is possible? So find this. Then 84 5s are, so R should be 5%. Simple calculation. Then next question, you can see is the interest on certain deposit at 4.5% is 405 in 1 year. The interest on certain deposit at 4.5% is 405 rupees on 1 year. How much additional interest can be earned in 1 year on same deposit at 5%? Okay, so here let first find the principal. So interest is 405. 4.5% I can write as 9 by 2. So this is POP in 1 year. So you can find this. 9 fours are 36. So this is 45. So your principal is 9,000. Your principal is 9,000. So what they're asking you? They're asking you how much additional interest. So additional means earlier you're getting 4.5%. Now if you get 5%, so what is the additional interest? Half percent. Half percent means 1% is 1/100. So half percent is 1/200. So additional will be 1/200 of 9,000. Solve this. the answer would be 45 degrees. Simple calculation. Then next question. The sum of money was invested in a bank at 8% simple interest for 3 years. The sum of money, 8% simple interest for 3 years. Instead, if you have invested for 8.5% simple interest for the 4 years, the earning would have been 500 rupees more. So what is the sum invested? So then what you can do for this question, that here in this question they are mentioning, they have mentioned the sum of money was invested in simple interest at 8% for 3 years. Okay, then if this was invested at 8.5% for 4 years, the earning would have been 500 rupees more. So you can suppose your principal is P. So in both the case it's P only, and here you are getting 8.5% 0.085 into 4 years minus, and here you are getting 8% for 3 years, and the difference of this is 500 rupees. So you have to find the value. So you need to solve this. 85 tusa is 170, and 170 tusa is 340. So 85 tusa is 340. So 85 tusa is 340, and 3 decimal is there. 0.34, this is 0.34, and this is 0.24, this is 0.24, so the difference is 0.1, so the difference is 0.1 P is equal to 500, so the value of P is 5000. Simple calculation. Then the next question, you can see the next question that a person borrowed 600 rupees at 3% per annum and 800 rupees at 4.5% per annum on agreement. That whole sum will be returned only when the total interest become 270 rupees. So the number of year after which this borrowed sum will be returned is. So the time is, suppose that is T year, okay. Suppose that time is supposed T year, so 600 at 3%. So the 1% of 600 is 6. So 3% would be 18. So that would be 18 plus. So 4.5% of 800. So 4.5%. So 1% of 800 is 8. 1% is 8. And half percent would be 4. And 4% would be 8 fours are 32. So 8.5% would be 36. So this will become, after how many, this will become 270. 18 plus 36 is 54. You need to solve this. So 270 divided by 54. This is 5 years. This will happen after 5 years. Fine. So you can solve the question very easily. Now see the question number 10. So the next question is, a sum of money amount to 1180 and 1330 in 3 year and 5 year. So at simple interest per annum, what is the money invested was? So become 1180 in 3 year. So it will become 1180 P plus PRT. So in 3 year, 3PR by 100. This is the amount formula in simple interest. And it become 1300 in 5 years. 1300 in 5 years. 5 PR by 100. So you can solve this. Subtract the equation 1. from equation 2, it becomes 120 into PR by 100. So it becomes, you can say PR by 100, this is 60, and then it becomes 6000. So the value of P into R is 6000. Substitute this value in any equation, suppose equation 2. So substitute in equation 2, 1300 plus P plus 5 by 100 into 6000. If you write, you get 300. So the value of principal, you'll get is 1000. What they're asking you? They're asking you the principal only, how much is the money invested? That is 1000. Okay. Then see the next question. Question number 11. So a bank lent 4000 rupees to a person A at certain rate of simple interest and 5000 to B at 5%, at half percent more than A. At half percent more than A. So a bank lent 4000. So bank lent 4000. Suppose at R percent and B. So B at R plus 0.5%. Okay. After 2 years, the bank received 860. So as the interest. So after 2 years, so what is the interest he'll get on 4000? So what is R percent of 4000? So R percent of 4000. So let it be. So after 2 years, they have mentioned. So 4000 into R into that is into T. Divide by 100 and then R plus, this is 8000. So 8000 and then so then this would be 8000 into R by 100 for 2 years. This would be 10000 into R plus 0.5 by 100 and that total is 860. After 2 years, you need to find this value of R. So you're understanding, 4000 P into R into T. So principal is 4000 times 2 years. So 4000 into 2, that is 8000. Here the principal is 5000 times 2 years. So after 2 years, 5000 will become 10000. So I can write this is 80R plus, this is how much? 100 R plus 0.5. That is equal to 860. So I can write this as 80R plus 100R plus 50 is equal to 860. This is 180R is equal to 830. So what is the value of R? So this is 810, not 830. This is 810. So the value of R, value of R would be how much? 4.5%. So the value of R would be 4.5%. So that would be 9 by 2. So 81 by 18. 9 nines are 81. So 18 is 2 are 4.5%. So they're asking you at find the rate of interest at which the amount was lent to B. So they're asking you if how much it was lent to A. So A at R percent and B at R plus 0.5%. So what is R plus 0.5%? That would be 5%. The rate of interest at which it was lent to B was 5%. Now see the next question. Next question is simple interest on certain sum of money for 3 years at 8%. Simple interest for 3 years at 8% is half. So 3 years at 8% is 0.24p. That is a simple interest. This is half of the compound interest for 4000 for 2 years at 10%. So 4000, 10% is the rate of interest. You will get 400. It becomes 4400. Again 10%. This would be 440. So the total interest is 840. So this is half of 840. So half of 840. This is what? 24 by 100 P equal to 420. So 24 fives are, I think is 24 fives are. No.
24 by the number,
then this will be what? So let's solve this. So the value of P is 42,000 divided by 24. Then you can, in 6 table, this is 6 7s are, this is 6 4s are, then the value of P, this is 1s are, then 30 means 7s are, then 1750. That is the value of P. The next question. So if the annual rate of interest of simple interest increased from 10 to 12.5, a man yearly income increased by 1250. So from 10% to 12.5, what is the increase? 2.5%. 2.5% is the 1/4 of 10%. Okay, so I can say 1/4 of 10%. So is 2.5%. 2.5%. 10% is 2.5. So what is the principal? So that increases, so that P into 10 by 4,000. Why I'm writing 4,000? 10 by 400. This is 10%. This is equal to 1250. So 125 4s are, 125 2s are is 250. Then 5,000. So your answer would be, so this is 125 4s are is 500. Then 2 more 0. So that would be 50,000. This would have been better if I have written that 2.5%. It would have been better, 1.25. So this is 25 fives up. This would have been 50,000. This calculation would be much more better. A man invested an amount of 8,000 in FD for 2 years at compound interest at 5%. How much he get on maturity? So he invested in FD of 8,000 for 2 years, and the compound interest is 5%. So what is 5% of 8,000? That would be 400. So you will become 8,400. Again 5%. What is 10%? Is 840. 5% is 420. So now 420 means 8820. Simple. Now going further. So this question number 15. So the compound interest on certain sum for 2 years at 10% is 525 is the compound interest. You know the formula of compound interest, E into 1 plus R by 100 to the power T minus 1. The compound interest is 525 and the rate of interest is 10%. So that 10%, what is for 2 years? So you can write this as 1 plus 10 by 100 to the power 2 minus 1. So you can write this as 525 into T. This will be nothing but 1.1 to the power 2 minus 1. 1.1 square is 1.21 minus 1 is 0.21. So 0.21 P is equal to 525. So 21 2za is 42. So then it will be 15. So this would be 1500. That would be your principal. Okay, 21 into 15 is 525. 21 2za 42. So 21 2za 42, then 105. 21 5za 105. So principal is 2500. So your principal is 2500. So your principal is S2500. So your principal is 2500. Then what they are asking you? They are asking you the simple interest on same sum. So sum is 2500. They are asking you the simple interest for same sum for double the time. Time double means 4 years and half the rate of interest. Rate of interest 10%. Half of that is 5%. This 00 get cancelled. So this is 500. You can see that next question, the difference between compound interest and simple interest on 15,000. So the difference between compound interest and simple interest on 15,000. 15,000 is your principal for 2 years is 96. Already we have discussed the difference formula between compound interest and simple interest for 2 years. That is PR square by 10,000. And that formula, that is you got the difference is 96. Your principal is 15,000, so you can find the value of R. Simple calculation. So what is the value of R? R is the square root of 96 into 10 to the power 4 divided by your principal is 15,000. You need to solve this. That will give you the value of R. So this is 10, this is 2za, this is 3za. 3za means this is 32 into 3 is 64. The value of R is 8%. Fine. I hope these all were easy questions. I don't think you find anything difficulty to solve these questions. These all were easy questions. I hope you enjoyed this solving these questions. So you can solve this question very easily. You don't need formulas and all. If you use the application of percentage, that is more than enough. With the application of percentage, you can get the answer very easily. So till now, all the questions we did it very easily. Fine. So already I told you the formula and all, difference formula and all. You can do it very easy. Now you read question number 17. Now to solve question number 17, you should understand the principle of NUT and all the concept of NUT. So till now I told you the formula of amount. This in compound interest, we know the formula of amount. This is amount is equal to principal 1 plus R by 100 to the power. We know this formula. Now you can write the same formula as amount is equal to principal 1 plus R percent to the power T. You can write the same formula like this way. Now I can consider my principal as the present value. I can consider the principal as the present value and amount as the future value. I can derive this formula. So the same formula we use in time value of money. So I believe if you have seen my previous video definitely. You have seen, I have discussed this formula. If I talk about present value of money, then the present value of money is future value divided by 1 plus R by 100 to the power T. Okay, then I have discussed the concept of multi-period compounding also. So when we talk about multi-period compounding, it depends from institution to institution. Like if you talk about banks, so banks in our country give interest per day basis. So whenever you go to bank and ask for the interest, they will ask you, they will mention, they will say that, okay, sir, if you put your money to us, they'll say, if you put money to us, we'll give you this much interest. Like Kotak Mahindra Bank will give you 6% interest. Yes Bank will give you 7% interest. It depends from a banking institution to
banking institutions. It all depends on them. What we need to understand, like, suppose I went to a bank and asked for the interest rate. They told me that if whatever money you deposit to us on that money, we'll give you 4% interest per annum. But they calculate this interest per day, because banks works on asset liability management. And as per the RBI directions, the bank has to give you interest every day. So the interest, what is the rate of interest what the bank offers you per day would be? So the rate of interest what the bank offers you per day. So the rate of interest per day, that value would be 4% divided by 365. That would be this value the bank gives you per day. This is the rate of interest per day basis. And that is 4% divided by 365. So you need to understand this concept. Like, suppose there's a person called Mohan, and suppose Mohan has deposited 1,000 rupees in a bank for 4 years. Okay. So then what is the future value of the money Mohan will get? That would be 1,000 into 1 plus 4% divided by 365. This is the interest what the bank is giving to Mohan every day. And now, because bank gives interest every day, so in 1 year, the bank will calculate the interest 365 times. So in 4 years, the bank will calculate the interest 4 into 365 times. So you need to understand this concept. So this is called multi-period compounding. So in last class, I have given you the example of Kisan Vikas Patra, like post office. If you go and deposit your money in post office, so the post office will give you 8% per annum. Post office will give you 8% per annum compounded half yearly. So 8% per annum compounded half yearly. So 8% per annum compounded half yearly will become how much? It will become 8.16%. Okay, for 1 year. So I have discussed this. This is what is called as effective interest rate. So sometime in exam and all, they may ask you the concept of effective interest rate. So remember the formula of effective interest rate. The formula is 1 plus annualized interest rate. The formula is 1 plus annualized interest rate divided by m to the power m minus 1 into 100. This is the concept of effective interest rate. Now, what is m? So m is the adjustment factor. That would be 1 if the rate of interest is compounded annually. M would be 2 if the rate of interest is compounded half yearly. M would be 4 if the rate of interest is compounded quarterly. M would be 12 if the rate of interest is compounded monthly. I hope you understand. So here you understand. So in that case, in that case of post office, that was 8% per annum, but they are compounding half yearly, so the m would be 2. So if you want the value of effective interest rate, you can calculate it like this way. So the effective interest rate, that is 1 plus 4% to the power 2 minus 1, 200. So the effective interest rate is 1.04 square minus 1 into 200. 1.04 square is how much? That is 1.0816. So that is 1.0816 minus 1 into 100. So you can find the effective interest rate at 0.0816 into 100. So that is around 18.16%. You need to understand this concept of effective interest rate. This is applicable in real market. Like if you go and if you need money, short term money, right now this is corona epidemic time, And if you go and ask money from bank and all, they will ask for a lot of documents and all to get the money. Now, if you go and ask the same money from some money lender, they'll give you the same money, but they will charge very high interest rate. You can even take money from them on 4-day basis or 15-day basis and all. So there you can calculate this effective interest rate. In real market, we actually use effective interest rate. So if you can understand it well and good, otherwise you can keep this in your mind that in the formula and all, which is your adjustment factor, which I called as the adjustment factor. So the M would be 1 if the rate of interest is compounded annually. This M would be 2 if the rate of interest is compounded half yearly. M would be 4 if the rate of interest is compounded quarterly. Then M would be 12 if the rate of interest is compounded monthly. And M would be 365 if the rate of interest is compounded per day basis. Similarly, if I talk about per second basis, then you can understand M would be 365 into 24 into 3600. So in 1 year, you have 365 days. In 1 day, you have 24 hours. In 1 hour, you have 3600. So that way, if you calculate, you understand the amount would be equal to principal into 1 plus r percent divided by 365 into 24 into 3600 to the power. So you can write as 365 into 24 into 3600 time. So you can write the same thing. This is equal to p into e to the power rt. This is called continuous compounding. So this is applicable whenever the rate of compounding is exponential. If it happening exponentially basis, then you use this formula. This is called continuous compounding. You can remember this formula. This is applicable in higher finance and all. So we use this where E, what is E? E is the Euler number. The E is an irrational number which gives you value around 2.71828. This is an irrational number. So I believe you should learn E the same way we give a relevance to the pi, like the same way you can learn about E. So whenever you have the question where the rate of interest is compounding half yearly, quarterly and all, so you can use the formula called P into 1 plus R percent by M to the power MT. Or you can write P into 1 plus effective interest rate to the power T. You do anyway, you will get the same answer. So it's all up to you. Depending upon question to question, you can apply anything and you will get the same answer. So keep that in your mind. Suppose I have deposited 1,000 rupees in post office, 1,000 rupees in post office, which offers 8% per annum, compounding half yearly. Okay, so the total amount, what I will get back after three years. If I ask you this, so what I'm doing, I'm depositing 1,000 rupees in a post office, which is giving me 8% per annum, and that is compounding half yearly. So what is the total amount I'll get back after 3 years? Suppose if I ask you this question, so how to will you do this? So the one way of doing is amount is equal to principal. So your principal is 1,000. This money I'm depositing, in post office, the rate of interest, this is half yearly. So this is 8% divided by 2. And the money what I'll get back after 3 years. So every year you get 4% interest, and in 1 year if you calculate the interest 2 times, so in 3 years you get calculate interest 6 times. So you'll get this money. So you can do a question like this, or what you can do, you can find the effective interest rate of 8%. So the effective interest rate of 8% already I have done, that was 8.16%. So to the power 3. If you do this calculation in both the way, you'll get the same answer. So 1000 into 1.08 to the power 6, that is 1000 is equal to 1.0816 to the power 3. You can check this, both will give you the same answer. This is just an understanding I want to develop. So that you can while you solve the question and all, you can keep this concept in your mind. This is, you can see, if I say 1.08 to the power 1.04 to the power 6, you can see 1265.32. Sorry, this is 1. This is 1.04. So this is, and then you can see this. This is 1000 into 1.0816 to the power 3. You'll get the same answer. So I hope you understood this concept. So keep this concept in your mind. This is very helpful. It will be helpful for you. And now if you have forgotten this, so this how I got this 8.16. If you remember, this was 8%, which is compounding half yearly. If you remember, I did this calculation. You remember this, right? I did this calculation already. So if it 8%, then you can, if it compounding half yearly, that you'll get 8.16%. This I did, and in previous class also, I have discussed this 0 to 6 month, and then 7 to 12 month, and 0 to 6 month, and then 7 to 12 month. So 8% per annum compounding half yearly, that would be 4% and 4%. That 4% will not be 4% here. So you'll get 4% on 4%. So 4% on 4% is 4.16%. So you'll get 8.16%. And so I think I spent a lot of time trying to make you understand this concept. This is something which you should work on. And more you work on, better it would be for you to understand the concept. Now, till now, whatever the example I have given you, for investment and all. In all such examples, we are talking about the investment. Here I'm talking about one-time investment. This is called one-time investment or lump sum. This is called lump sum or one-time investment. This formula and all, what I told you, this formula and all, these all are one-time investment where you use the formula called future value is equal to present value into 1 plus R by 100 to the power T. Or present value is equal to future value into 1 plus R by 100 to the power T. So these all are one-time investment. I'm talking about one-time investment by using this formula. Now the next thing you should understand, that the next thing you need to understand is the concept of NUT. Next thing you need to understand is the concept of NUT. What do you mean by NUT? NUT means that when you receive or you pay the same amount of money, when you receive or you pay the same amount of money, the same amount of money, if you receive or you pay the same amount of money after every regular interval of time, after every regular interval of time for certain year is called as NUT. This money is called as NUT. Is called as NUT. This is called as NUT. This we called as NUT. So when you receive or when you pay the same amount of money after every regular interval of time till certain time, that is called as NUT. NUT is like the money what you receive as a pension. So the money what you get as a pension, like when you die, get retired, or once you get retired from your job, government will give you a certain amount of money after every month. So in your account, you get that money. So if you notice, that money will remain the same. That money does not get changed. So you need to you get that. So this is called as this one. This is called as NUT. Okay. Now NUT maybe is EMI. The EMI what you give on a loan. That is again the concept. That is again the concept of NUT. So these all are the example of NUT. So NUT basically means when you pay or when you receive. So whenever you say NUT, NUT basically means that when you pay or when you receive the same amount of money after every regular interval of time, that is basically called an NUT. So you need to get the logic of NUT very well. So once you understood this concept of NUT, once you understood the concept of NUT, then the next thing you need to understand, then the next thing you need to understand is the future value of NUT and the present value of NUT. So this is a direct formula. Derivation and all is there, but I don't think you'd be interested for derivation. Future value of NUT, that is A divided by R percent into 1 plus R percent to the power T minus 1. This is the formula of future value of NUT. And this is the formula of present value of NUT. A divided by R percent into 1 plus R percent to the power T minus 1 divided by 1 plus R percent to the power T. This is the formula of present value of NUT. So normally future value of NUT concept we use for sinking fund, like, or when you work on your financial dream. So then your dream you'll put as your future value of NUT. Like suppose the question is that I want to have a house. I want to have 2 BHK house in Bangalore after 5 years, something like that, simple. So I want to have two BHK house in Bangalore after 5 years. So the question is that how much can I deposit in my account every month? Okay, so that on that SIP, whatever SIP or mutual fund, which offers me 15% per annum, I'll get my financial dream of house, which is around maybe 70 lakh rupees, something like that. So here, what would be this? So this formula you use for that. This formula you use for this, or do this calculation. To do this calculation, you are going to use this formula. So on future value of NUT, is like suppose 75 lakh rupees house I want to buy, maybe after 5 years. So NUT, what is NUT? NUT basically means the money what you receive or you pay. Okay, so you pay every month to the mutual fund, which gives you 15% per annum, so that you get your house, your dream house after 5 years. So that NUT is what? NUT is the money what you're putting in that mutual fund. I hope you're understanding. So the NUT is that money. So this NUT you want to know. So how much can I put? So A divided by R percent. Suppose the mutual fund is giving you 15% interest per annum. And the money you're putting per month. So just divide by 12. Per month is value. So this 1 plus 15% divided by 12. And I want my dream to be achieved after 5 years. I want my dream to be achieved after 5 years. So in every month, if you're putting this money, so you have to put this money for 60 times. You do this calculation, you will get the answer. So this is the application, this NUT and all. So whenever you pay money, whenever you think about future, when you are thinking about your future, So you are depositing money. So whenever you deposit money or whenever you pay money, you think about your future. So so that way you want to know the future value of the money. You understand how much the money will become. So the corpus, how much the money will become. So there you use the concept of future value of annuity. So how much your money will become. So there you use the concept of future value of annuity. And then the formula for that is this is the formula for future value of annuity. So you can use this formula and you can get the answer for that. Whenever this this kind of scenario comes, so you apply future value of annuity, the formula is A divided by R percent into 1 plus R percent to the power T minus 1. And with that, you get the future value of annuity. You work on the future value of annuity. Now, when we use present value of annuity, present value of annuity, you basically use when you want to know that when you receive money, whenever you receive money, and suppose every month you are receiving some amount of money, maybe your insurance policy, something got expired, and you had done a lot of investment in your parts. Now every month that insurance company is giving you some amount of money. Okay, so these are all the scenario of present value of money. So if you have done some investment, now every month you are getting some money. You are getting some money like that. So what is the total money I'll get after 10 years? You understand? So if every month somebody is giving me some money, so what is the sum total of all the money I'll get? So there, whenever you receive the money, you use the present value of annuity concept. Okay, this is called present value of annuity. So where you determine the present value of the money what you are getting. Okay, so this all works on GP and all. So like this is year, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 like that. So you can now the annuity, the money what you are getting. Suppose after every regular interval of time, I'm getting A rupees for N year. I'll get A rupees for N year. I'll get A rupees, and the rate of discounting, the rate of interest is R percent. 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 So now you can determine the present value of this. This would be A divided by 1 plus R percent power 1. Okay, this is the present value. So I after 1 year, if I get A, what is the present value of this my money? So if after 2 years, if I get A, what is the present value of that? 1 plus R percent to the power 2. If after 3 years, if I get R, so what is the present value of the money to the power 3? You understand? So after N year, what is the present value of money? 1 plus R percent to the power 3. So with this, you can find the sum total of all the money what you get. That is called present value of annuity. So with that, you get the present value of annuity. That is, so the present value of this annuity, this is what I get after 1 year. Then this is the present value of what I'm getting after 2 years, like this. So that divide by 1 plus R percent to the power n. This is the present value of annuity. Every year you are getting A rupees. So after 1 year I get A rupees, after 2. Annuity means the money should be same. So every year if I'm getting A rupees, after 1 year, so I'm getting A rupees, what is the present value of that? After 2 years you get A rupees, what is the present value of that? So sum total of all the money what you're getting is the present value of annuity. So now in order to solve this, if you notice, these all are in GP. If you notice, they are in GP. So where the ratio is 1 divided by 1 plus R percent, and your first term is A divided by 1 plus R percent. Don't get confused with A and A. This is your first term. Maybe you are getting confused. So let me write. This is your first term. So in GP, what is the sum of N terms in GP? That is A. Maybe now if you again you get confused, I should write first term. Yeah, A into 1 minus R to the power N by 1 minus R. This is the formula what we use. So now if you find the sum of this, So then you get the present value of NUT. Your first term is A divided by 1 plus R percent into 1 minus, what is the ratio? 1 by R percent to the power N divided by 1 minus 1 by 1 plus R percent. And solve this. So this is the present value of NUT. So the present value of NUT is A divided by 1 plus R percent. So you can solve this. This is 1 plus R percent to the power N minus 1 divided by 1 plus R percent to the power N. This is 1 plus R percent minus 1 divided by 1 plus R percent. This get cancelled. This get cancelled. So ultimately, you got the formula called A divided by R percent into 1 plus R percent to the power N minus 1 divided by 1 plus R percent to the power N. So this is the present value of NUT formula. So present value of NUT formula we normally use whenever we receive money. Okay. So the same formula of present value of NUT you can use whenever the question comes related to loan also. So the same formula of present value of NUT you can use whenever the question comes related to the loan. So you can use the same formula there also. Whenever there's a question related to loan, you can use the same formula. So in place of present value of NUT, you can write loan, and in place of A, you can write EMI. So whenever you take loan from a bank, the bank charge EMI and all. So that same calculation you can use here. So you can use the same calculation, because loan EMI we pay per month. So that's why I'm dividing the R by 12, and you have to multiply the time by 12. So this formula you can use. This formula whenever there's a question related to loan, and you can solve this to get the answer. So this you can do it. So loan and all, so you can do this calculation and you can get the answer very easily. I hope you understand this. So now this question you can see question number 17. So how to do this question number 17? Now how to do this question number 17? So John borrowed. So here in this question, John borrowed so this much. So whatever I told you, loan is nothing but when you talk of loan, or that is the present value of NUT. So that is your present value of NUT. That is 210,000. So this is the money borrowed at the rate of 10% per annum. So your rate is 10% per annum. Okay, and compounded annually. The loan is paid in two equal installment. The first after 1 year, second after 2 years, that every year only. They are talking yearly basis. So no need to divide the R by 12 amount. So they are talking yearly basis amount, because here calculator is not allowed. So they cannot give a complicated calculation. Okay, fine. So what they are asking you, so the time is 2 years. Your time is 2 years. So they're asking you installment. So you mean they're asking you EMI. So the same formula, present value of NUT, you apply the formula. And you can write A divided by R percent into 1 plus R percent to the power P minus 1 divided by 1 plus R percent to the power P. You can solve this. So present value of NUT is 210,000. And your A is what you have to determine. R is 10%, 10% is 1. So I hope you understand. No need of wasting my time writing 1 plus 10% or 1 plus 10 divided by 100. Then you write 1 by 10, then 1 plus 1 by 10 is 11.11 by 10 or 1.1. I hope by this time you easily understand this to the power minus 1 divided by 1.1 to the power. So this would be 21,000. This is A. So
this is A, this is 0.21 divided by 1.21. So I can cancel the decimal, this would be 1000. Then the value of A is 121 into 1000. 121.
Simple. This question came in CAT exam. But you can see this is very easy, provided if you know the concept of NUT. If you know the concept of NUT, then this question would be very easy. So here, when I'm using this calculation and all, when I'm discussing these formulas and all, this calculation of GP and all, well, I worked on the calculation of GP because this money should be same. So if the money is same, so you no need of creating a complicated calculation. The same thing you could have done very easy. If the money is not same, then you have to do step by step, then you left with no option. You have to solve it by step, every year you need to discount it and then only you get the answer. Fine, without that it will be difficult for you. Fine, so going further, next question you can see. Next question. On certain sum of money, compound interest at the end of 3 years is 1456 and compound interest after 2 years is 880. Compute the principal invested. You see the question number 18. So this question came in PGCET exam 2018. Also, this question came in past in CAT exam also. So everyone please try. The answer is 2000. See how you can get the answer. So you can work on calculation. So it's not at all difficult. So compound interest after the end of 3 years. So the compound interest after 3 years. So I can write P into 1 plus R by, instead of R by 100, let me write R just for making the calculation easy. That is 1456, and for 2 years, that is 1 plus R by 100 to the power 2 minus 1, so that is 880. Now divide the equation 1 from equation 2. What you need to find, you need to find the principal. So divide the equation 1 from equation 2, so you get 1 plus R by 100 to the power T minus 1, that is divided by 1 plus R by 100 to the power 2 minus 1, that is equal to 1456 divided by 880. So I can do the calculation. I can write this as 1 will get cancelled. So anyway, I can open this A square A cube plus B cube plus 3A square B plus 3AB minus 1 divided by A square plus B square plus 2AB minus 1. So this is 728 divided by 440. This is 364 divided by 220. And this is 182 divided by 110. So this would be 91. 91 divided by 55. And then I can cancel 1 and 1 also. From both left hand side and right hand side. So then I left with R cube plus 3R square plus 3R divided by R square plus 2R is equal to 91 by 55. So then I can write R square plus 3R plus 3 into 55 equal to 91 into R plus 2. R and R I can remove both sides, I can cancel them. Then this equation will become 55R square plus 165R plus 165 equal to 91R plus 182. So I can write as 55R square plus 165R minus 91R plus 165 minus 182 is equal to 0. 5R square plus 74R, this is 65 minus 91, this is 74R, this is 74 R minus this is what 165 plus 15. If I do, I'll get 180 plus 217. So this would be minus 17 is equal to 0. Now 1755. 17 5 size 85. 85 is 85. So you'll get 935. So 80, this is what 17 into 55. That is 935. So what I can write this 17 into 5 into 11. So this I can write 85 and 11. This is 55 R square. Then minus 11 R plus 85 R minus 17 is equal to 0. So if I take common 11 R, I can take common. This is 5 R minus 1 plus 17. 17 means 5 R minus 1 equal to 0. So 11 R plus 17 is 5 R minus 1 is equal to 0. So the value of R you will get is 1 by 5 and minus 17 by 11. So the R value is 1 by 5. If you think in the term of percentage, so the R is 1 by 5. If you think in percentage, R percent, 1 by 5 into 100. So the R value you get is 20%. So, but they are not asking the R value. They are asking you the principal, right? So the simple, then compound it or something. So after 2 years, that is 880. So let's take that. So after 2 years, that is 880. After 2 years, so principal 1 plus R by 100 to the power 2 minus 1, that is 880 after 2 years. This is a principal they are asking you. So base of R, if I can write 20 by 100, so that doesn't matter. So to the power 2 minus 1 is equal to 880, or I can write 1 by 5 also. Both will give me the same thing. 20 by 100, anyways, 1 by 5. So 1 plus 1 by 5 is 6 by 5. So this is P into 1 plus 1 by 5 to the power 2 minus 1 is equal to 880. So this is P into 6 by 5 to the power 2 minus 1 is equal to 880. So you get P is equal to 36 by 25 minus 1 is equal to 880. This is P into 11 by 25 is equal to 880. This is 80. P is equal to 80 into 25. P is equal to 80 into 100 by 4. So you can write 25 as 100 by 4. This would be 2000. So you understand this. So altogether, you can do this calculation very easily. So solving them and all is not at all a big thing. 19 already I have done in the previous class. Now talking about 21, we are upon the same case again. 21 Ram answer is 0. I think I have done this question in previous class. I'm not sure about. Anyway, let's do it. I'm not sure if I've done or not. So 600 rupees as simple interest was for how many years? 2 years. No? So 2 years. So the simple interest for 2 years, that is 600, and compound interest for 2 years, that is 630. So you can find the difference. So the difference for 2 years is 30 rupees, and you know the difference formula. The difference formula for 2 years is PR square by 10,000. Already I told. I told this formula in the previous class. So if the difference between SI and CI after 2 years, this is the formula. The difference, if you have not seen, I don't know, you have seen my first session or not. I have discussed this formula already. So the difference between CI and SI after 2 years, the formula, the difference is PR square by 10,000. Similarly, the difference between CI and SI after 3 years, CI minus SI after 3 years is 3 R square into 300 plus R divided by 10 lakh. So remember this. So derivation or everything I have discussed in the first video. If you have not seen that, please go through that video. So that would be really helpful for you. So now you can write this as P R square. This is 403 into 10 to the power 5. So similarly, simple interest after 3 years 600. So you can write 2 P R by 100 is equal to 600. So you can write P R is equal to 300 into 20. So 3 into 10 to the power 4. So you can see P R square is 3 into 10 to the power 5, and P R is 3 into 10 to the power 4. So with that, if you divide the first from another, so the R value you get is 10%. Simple. And the R is 10%. Now see the question number 22. See this question. A money lender takes advantage of difficult situation of poor people and charges 50% interest. So suppose the person has 100 rupees, on that he'll charge 50% interest. So it becomes 150. And however, he never get caught because he give away 20% of total capital as a bribe. So 20% of this he give as a bribe. So 20% of this is 30. So ultimately he's getting 120 rupees. So every time he do this investment, every time he's doing this investment, he's earning how much? He's earning 20%. You can either do like this way, or you can apply a successive percentage change also. So successive percentage change, if you calculate, I discussed that formula in the percentage class. So the formula is x percent plus y percent plus xy by 100%. So you are getting 50% and you are paying 20% bribe. So plus into minus is minus. That is 50 into 20 divided by 100. This is 30. This is 1000. This is 10. This is 20%. You can either do like this way. Anyway, you'll get the same logic. I hope you understand it. So, if this person gave as lending, suppose this person lent 100 rupees to the other person, so he got 150 rupees from that, and out of 150 rupees, 20% of what he got, he gave as a bribe. So, 20% of 150 is 30, so he get back 120 rupees. So, the net in return on the investment, now the net return here on investment, net return on investment is 20%. Net return on investment is 20%. I hope you understood this. So the net return on the investment is 20%. Then because he never get caught because he give 20% of the capital as a bribe. So you need to understand that 20, you need to understand 20 plus 20 will become 50. So 20 plus 20, will it become 50? 20 plus 20, it will become 44, not 50. So 50 minus 20 is 20. And this is the beauty of compounding. So you need to understand 50 minus 20 is actually 20. So this is the beauty of compounding. So now, so you can understand. So what they are asking you, so if in the beginning of fourth year, he has a capital of 25,000 rupees to invest, how much bribe he gave at the end of second year? So you understand this. Suppose the person has 100 rupees, suppose. So after first year, so after giving bribe, he will have 120 rupees. Similarly, after 2 years, after giving bribe, he will be 144 rupees. Okay, so 20% on this. So how much he bribe he gave at the end of second year? Let me do this calculation, because we should know this. Let me do this calculation. This is 120 after first year. So then next year he invested, he got 50% on that. His money become 180. Okay, then on 180 he gave 20% bribe. 20% of this is 36 rupees. You need to understand. Then it become 144 rupees. So the second year bribe is 36 rupees. Okay. Then third year, can I do direct 20%? It become 172.8. Okay. So you understand this. No? So now, if the beginning of fourth year, so beginning of fourth year means what? At the end of third year. So at the beginning of fourth year, he have this money, 172.8. He have 172.8. If he started with 100 rupees, but in reality, if he have 25,000 rupees, so he started with what money? So you can find that. So what is that money? This, what is this X? So what is this X? So you can find that ratio. So what is, how will you find that ratio? So you can find this ratio. So I assume I started with 100. I know that is not 100. I could have done with X also, but with X the situation tends to be a little complicated. So you can do that. With this, how much is this X? So this X would be 100 divided by 172.8. And this is 25,000. This is my X. So now you can understand this. You can understand this scenario. They are asking you the bribe. The bribe that they are asking you, this value of 36. So you can start with 36. What would be that value? 36. Mm-hmm. So if once you get that, so you can find that value. So how much bribe he gave at the end of second year? So he gave 36 rupees as a bribe. So you need that bribe, right? So you could have done in the term of 36 only. So this you could have done. So at the end of 172.8 is the money. This is the end of third year or the beginning of fourth year. I hope you understand. Or the beginning of fourth year. End of third year or beginning of fourth year, that is 172.8. So then, so in when you can write this is in reality is 25,000. So 172.8 in reality is 25,000. Because if you go with the real money, I don't know what is the money he started with, then it will reach 25,000 if you go with real money. While when I'm assuming 100, I'm getting 172.8. So in accordance of that, if this is 36, what would be the real money? So I can find this. So I can do that. So that this would be how much? This would be 25,000. This would be 25,000 divided by 172.8. I can solve this. So this is 25,000, then one more zero. So this is 178.36. Then this will be what? This will go by 6 now. This will go by 6. It will go by 12. 178. It will go by 12. This is 12 threes are. This is 12 144. 12 cube is 178. So this is 4s. This is 8s. So this is 48. So bigger number. This will go with 16. So 16 and all, it would go by 16. 16 when the 16. Then 16 plus 25 is 9. 90 means what? 90 means 5 za 80. 90 means 5 za 80, 80 means 100, 100 means 6 za 96, 96, 96 means 4 za 96, 96 means 40, 40 means 2 za, then 5 za. 2 za is 32, then 80 is 5 za. 16, 3 za 48. 15625 divided by 3. So this is 5 za. Then this is 2 za. Then this is 0. Then 8 za. Then 10. So 5208.33. Okay. You'll get the answer. Thank you. So not at all a difficult problem. You can do it very easily. This question I have done in the previous class. So I assume the simple interest is X. So the same logic. So simple interest as X. So compound interest would be 2X. This already I did in the first class. So compound interest and after 2 years twice of the simple interest. And you know the formula of the difference between two compound interest and simple interest. That is PR squared by 10,000. So the difference between them is X. So you can write PR squared is equal to 10,000X. And similarly, simple interest after 2 years, that is 2 PR by 100, that is equal to X. So I can write PR. So PR, this is 50, this is 500X. So it's not 50x, so not 500x, 50x. This is 50x. So I can find the value of r. I just need to divide. So 10,000 divided by 50. So 10,000 divided by 50 will get 200%. Already I have done that. This also 24 also I did in the previous class. And then 30% of the rest is the investment stock. Let us go to the saving account. Already I have done that. Now see this 25 question. Now see this, Gopal borrows X rupees from Ankit at 8% annual interest. He then add Y rupees of his money and lend X plus Y to Ishan at 10%. Okay, so at the end of the year after returning Ankit due, the net interest retained by Gopal is same as that what he accrued to Ankit. So the money accrued to Ankit was how much? That is 0.08X. No? Then the money what he gets from Ishan is 10% of X plus Y. This is the money what he gets from Ishan. From this 8% of X is the money what he gives to Ankit. And then after he gives the money to Ankit, the money left with him is same as the money what he gave to Ankit. And the money left with him is 0.08X. Only. So you can write this as 0.1X plus 0.1Y. Equal to this is 0.16x. 0.08 plus 0.08. So this is 0.16. So I can say 0.1y is equal to 0.06x. So I can say, so this is what? This is y by 10 equal to 6x by 100. So I can say this. So I can say this y is equal to 3 by 5 of x. So I can establish this relation y is equal to 3 by 5 of x. So 6 by 10, that is 3 by 5. Okay. So after return on the other hand, had the Gopal lent x plus 2y to Ishan at 10%, had the Gopal lent X plus 2Y to Ishan at 10%. So 10%. So
the money he will get back is x plus 2y. Then the net interest retained by him would have increased by 50 rupees. Now the money what he'll get back is, at the end of the day, the money what he get back is from this 8% he'll give to Ankit. So the now the money which is left with him, earlier that was 0.08x, and that has increased by 150. Okay. So this is what is given. So I, in place of y, find the value of x plus y. So I can, what I can do, now I know the relation between x and y. So in place of y, I can write 3/5. So you can write this 2y. So the 2y would be 6/5x. So 2y is equal to, you can understand, 6/5x. So if I ask you what is x plus 2y, that is 6/5x plus x. So you'll get 11x/5. So this is 11x/5. So 0.1 into 11x/5 minus 4, this minus 1. This, if you bring that side, if you take it that side, it becomes 0.16x plus 150. So I can solve this. This is 10% of that is 1.1. Then 1.1 divided by 5. 1.1 divided by 5. If I ask you 1.1 divided by 5, that would be 0.22. That is that. So 0.22. So 0.22x minus 0.16x equal to 150. So you will get 0.06. 16 plus 6, 0.06x is equal to 150. So so you can write 0.06 means 6/100. 6/100, this you can write 6/100x equal to 150. This is 2za, this is 50za, this is 25. The value of x is 2500. The value of x is 2500. So you can find the value of y. Y is equal to 3/5x. Y is equal to 3/5x, 2500. So y is equal to 1500. What is x plus y? That will be 4000. Now see the next question. Question number 26. A person invested a total amount of 15 lakh. A part of it was invested in FD. Earning 6% annual interest, and the remaining amount was invested in two other deposits in the ratio 2:1, earning the annual interest at the rate of 4 and 3% respectively. If the total interest income is 76,000, then the money what is invested in FD? This is the question. A person invested total amount of 15 lakh rupees. Person invested a total amount of 15 lakh rupees. Okay. So a part of which was invested in FD at 6%. Okay. So at 6%. And the remaining amount was invested into deposit. So suppose remaining amount is A. So this would be 15 minus A. So, and that is deposited in the ratio 2:1. So this is 2/3 at A, and this is A/3. This is 2:1 ratio. And so this was invested at 4%. This is invested at 4%. And this is invested at 3%. So you can find the interest income, I think. So if the total annual interest income, they're talking about 1 year. So the interest what you'll get here is
6% of 15 minus a. So the 6% of 15 minus a is the same thing. 6%, 1% of 15 is 0.15. So 6% would be 2 decimal, 0.9. So this would be 0.9 minus 0.068. So the interest. Here this interest would be 2 by 3, 4% of a. So this would be 0.08 by 3a. This would be 0.03a by 3. So the total interest would be, to add them together, so that is 0.9 minus 0.06a plus 0.08a plus this is, so leave it, keep it like that, 0.03 by 3, keep it like that. Total interest you're getting is 76,000 something. So the total interest you're getting is 76,000. So the total interest you're getting is 76,000. This is your total interest. Okay, now the guys, you need to understand this. This will not be 76,000, this is 0.76. Because you notice here, everything is in lakh. So 15, I wrote as 15 and all, so all are in lakh. If you understand, all are in lakh. So the total interest you earned is 76,000. If you convert in lakh, that will be 0.76. So lakhs, so all figures are in lakh. So you can understand that part. So this would be, if I bring this side, so this would be 0.14. So 0.14, then if I take all A together, 0.14, if I take all A together, this would be, this 0.016, I can write 0.18 by 3 minus 0.08, all are in A, and then minus 0.03, all are A. So this would be 0.42 is equal to, this is 0.1 minus 0.03. So that would be 0.07. So 0.07a. So 2 decimal, this would be 6. The value of a is 6. So 6 lakh means the a value. So they are asking us, then the amount in lakh invested in FD. So they are asking you this. So this is this a is 6 lakh. So what is 15 minus a? That would be 9 lakh. The total amount, part of it that was invested in FD, they are asking you this, 15 minus A. Okay, so they are in other deposit. This is FD and this is other deposit. Now, you can see this question number 27. See the question number 27. Question number 27 is like this. So Amal invests 12,000 rupees at 8% interest compounded annually. 8% interest compounded annually and 10,000 at 6% interest compounded semi-annually. So both investment for 1 year. So 12,000 at 8%. So 10% of 12,000 would be 1,200. So 8% of that would be 960 or 9600. 12,000. So that would be 960. 10% of that would be 10% of 12,000 is 1,200. So 8% would be 960. Okay. And 10,000, 6% compounded semi-annually. So compounded semi-annually already I discussed. So each semi-annually that would be 3%. So 3% of this, this is 10 to the power 4, 1% would be 100, 3% would be 300, so this would be 10,300, and then again 3%, so 1 year, so in 1 year you should compound it semi-annually, then you get the interest two time after 6 months and after 12 months. So 3% of this would be 309. So the total interest you receive is 609. So this is what 10,609. So the total interest you receive is 609. So here you got 609. Okay. So the total interest you got is how much? 1,569. And so Amal invest itna both invested for 1 year. So the total invested by Amal would be 960 plus 609. So this is 9. This is 6. 9 plus 6, 15. The total investment by Amal is 1,569. Abhimal invests his money at 7.5% simple interest for 1 year. 7.5 means 15/2. 15/2%. 15/2 means what? 7.5
is what? 7.5 is what? That is 15/2. 15/2 is 3/40. That is 15/200. Okay, and if the Bimal and Amal get the same amount interest invested by them, so both will get the same interest. That means the interest what Amal is getting 1,569, so Bimal will get the same money. So suppose the money of Bimal is X, so 15/200 of that is 1,569. So this is nothing but this is 3/40. So this is what? This is 523. So the X value is 523 into 4. 4 3s are 12, 1 carry, 8, 9, then 4 5s are 20. So 20920. So you need to find 523 into 40. You need to find 923 into 40. I think you are understanding this. So the step here is you have to find this 523 into 40. So that will give you 20920. Didn't see this question. Read the next question, everyone. Everyone, please try to do this question from your end. Thank you. Now see the next question. A father left a will of 35 lakh rupees between his two daughters who are aged 8.5 and 16 years, so that both of them get the equal amount when they reach 21 year. The original amount of 35 lakh rupees has been invested at 10% per annum. So how much their elder daughter get? So 35 lakh rupees that will be deposited. So the rate of interest is 10%. So the elder one is 16 year, and both will get the same money when they reach the 21 year. So her money. So the elder one, if I talk about elder one, if suppose she got A rupees, so her money will grow for how many years? 5 years. While if the younger one will get how much? 35 minus A, and her money will grow for how many years? So 8.5, 21 minus 8.5. So I can say 21 minus 9, 12.5 years. So for younger one, the money will grow for 12.5 years. And so both will get the same amount after 21 years. And the rate of interest is 10%. So rate of interest is 10%. Rate of interest is 10%. So the amount formula, you know. So the amount formula, you know, amount. The formula of amount is P into 1 plus RT by 100. This is the formula of amount. So principal is P, or principal here is A. So then 1 plus R is 10%. So R into 5, that is, if I write in the term of decimal, so 10%, I can write 0.1. 0.1 into 5 is 0.5. And here the money, this would be how much? So this is 35 minus A. 35 minus A, and this is 10% for 12.5 years. So 0.1 into, so this would be 1 plus 12.5 is 1.25. So both will get the same money. It means A into 1.5. So 1.5 A is equal to 2.25 into 35 minus A. So 1.5 I can write 3 by 2, 2.25 I can write 9 by 4 into 35 minus A. So this is how much? This is 3 by 2. So this I can write as 2A is equal to 105 minus 3A. So the value of A is 21. So the elder one, how much the money the elder one will get? That is 21 lakh rupees. Okay, then the next question. Question number 29. You can see question number 29, that the population of the town was 3600 3 year back. Now it is 4800. So you understand. So it was, you can think as a principal or present value. It was 3600. Amount is 4800 in 3 years. So you understand this. So you apply the formula. So you can get 4800. This is kind of amount of future value. Both more or less make the same sense. 4800 is equal to 3600 at 1 plus R by 100 to the power 3. So you can write this is 4 by 3 is equal to 1 plus R by 100 to the power 3. Take it together. Then what will be the population 3 years down the line? What will be the population 3 years down the line? So now the current population, now the population is 4800. They're asking you after 3 years, what will be the population? They're asking you the value of amount. So you need to understand this. So now the amount is 3 into 1 plus R by 100 to the power 3. They're asking after 3 years. So the principal, the current population right now 4800. 1 plus R by 100 to the power 3 is 4 by 3. You solve this. This is 18 fours are. This will be 7200. This much will be the population after 3 years. Very good question. It's more logical to solve. then see the next question. So a man invests 5,000 rupees for 3 years at 5% and compound interest, 5% per annum compound interest, reckoned yearly. Interest rate at the rate of 20% is earned on the interest. Whatever the interest I'm getting, 20% interest rate, I need to pay GST, interest rate, whatever. So if my money is 5,000 on that, I'm getting 5%. 5% on that is 250. So 250 is the interest what I get. Interest is 250. So on this 250, I need to pay tax of 20%. So tax of 20% means what is the means after tax, what I'm getting, that is 20% of this is 50. So I'm getting 200 rupees. So you need to understand this. So at the ultimate, although I earned an interest of 5%, so after deducting 20% on that, what I'm actually getting, whatever the interest I'm getting on that. So 20% once if I deduct from that, then what value I'm getting, that value is after deduction of 20%. You understand, income tax at the rate of 20% is reckoned, is 20% interest rate at the rate of 20% on the interest is deducted from each year. So 20% if I deduct from this, so the final I'll get is 200 rupees. So the money after the end of the year would be 5,200. Then again, next year you get 5% on that. So 5% of this is 260 rupees. 5% of this is 260. On this, if I pay 20% income tax or whatever the tax I'm paying, so 20% of this would be what, 52. Okay, so that is 52. If I deduct 52 from this, so I'll get 208 rupees. So then it would become 5,408. Then on 5,408, 5% interest, if I get 5% interest on that is 270.4. 5% on that is 270.4. On this, if I deduct 20%, 20% of this is what? 20% of this is 554.08. So the money left with me is, 216.32. So 5,408 plus 216.32. If I calculate, so plus 14. This is 5,424.32. Sorry, 5,6. This is 5,6. 5,624.32. You need to understand this. So here in this question, formula and all will not work. You need to understand. You are getting 5%. On that 5%, you are paying 20% tax. The left with you is 80%. So 80% of 5 is actually 4%. Understand this. So you are getting here 5%. Here you are getting 5%. Here you are getting 5%. On that, you are paying 20% tax. So if you deduct 20% from 5%. So if you deduct 20% from 5%, if you deduct 20% from 5%, it means ultimately you are getting 4%. So you could have done this question directly by taking 4%. So the same question you could do directly by taking 4%. Same question you could do directly by taking 4%. You could use eraser. Eraser is not working. So I'll show you this question. Same question. If you do it 4% for 3 years, for on 5,000, 4% if you do for 3 years, on 5,000 if you do 4% for 3 years, so 1% is 50. So 4% would be 200. So this would be 5,200. Again 4% on this. 1% is 52. Then this would be 208. So you get 5,408. Then again 4% on this. So 1% would be 54.08. Then 4% would be 61 carry. 216.32. So add 5408 plus 216.32. So you'll get 5624.32. So you understand? That means the same thing. Now see the next question. The difference between compound interest and simple interest on certain sum of money at 12% per annum for 2 years. You know the difference formula already. So the difference formula is ER square by 10,000, and that difference is given to you 90. So and rate is given 12%. So 12% square is 144. So 144 is equal to 9 into how many? 40. 9 into 10 to the power 5. So P equal to, will it go by 9? 16 nines are 144. So you will get 1 by 16 into 10 to the power 5. Okay. So this is your principal. So they are asking you what will be the amount at the end of 3 years. So this is your principal and rate of interest is 12%. So for 16%. 16 is 6.25. 1 by 16 is 0.1 by 16 is what? 1 by 10 is 10%, 1 by 11, 9.09, 1 by 12, 8.33, 1 by 30, 7.69%, 1 by 14, 7.14, 1 by 15 is 6.67, and 1 by 16 is 6.25. So 6.25 is 0.0625. 0.0625. 40. So this would be 6250. So this would be this. So if you solve this, so what would be the amount after 3 years? So this is the principal 6250, and find 12% of that. 10% of this. So 10% of this. 10% is 625. 1% is 62.5 into 2. 62.5 into 2, 62 is 124, 125. So 625 plus 125. So 625 plus 125, 750. You got 12% of this is 750. 750 plus 6250 is 7000. 7000. So 7000 plus again 12%. 12% now this would be 840. And 10% is 700, so 840 means 7840. So 7840 again 12%. This is after 1 year, this is after 2 year, after 3 year. So after 3 year, you want this value 12%. So 7840, 10% of that is 784. 10% is 784. 1% is 78.4 into 2. 8 is a 16. 14, 15. 156.8. This is 10. This is 13, 14, 7, 8, 9. 940.8. So 12% is 940.8. 7840, then 940.8. This is 0, 8, now 17. Then 8780.8. So you'll get the value called 8780.8. Okay. Then you can see this question. Son invested one half of his saving in the bond that pays simple interest for 2 years. So whatever the saving, suppose one half. Suppose half is A and A, okay. Suppose the total saving is 2A. suppose the total saving is 2. Once half of the saving at simple interest for 2 years and receive 550. One half of the saving, okay, and he received 550 rupees, okay, and he invested the remaining in the compound interest, compounded annually for 2 years, okay, at same rate of interest and earn 650. There you earn 650. So you understand this. So here that you can see total saving. Total saving is supposed to be, and so A rupees at simple interest for 2 years. The interest earned is 550, and then A rupees at compound interest for 2 years. The interest earned is 605. So now the difference. At 2 years, and that is 55 rupees. Okay, and you know the difference between SICI formula, that is PR square by 10,000, and that is 55. So P into R square is 55, then 5,50,000. You got this PR square is 5,50,000, and then simple interest for 2 years is 550. Simple interest for 2 years, that is 2 PR by 100 is equal to 550. So you can write this as, this is 275, then P into R is 275, then double zero. So now you can, if you solve PR squared by PR, you get R. R is 55, and then 40. Divide by 275 into 20. 55 5za is 275. Okay. This is 10 to the power 2. This is 5za. Then this is what 5za means. This is 20%. R is 20%. So they, I think they are asking R or what? No, they are asking you what is the value of total saving. So they are asking you 2a value. I got the R, so I can get the simple interest formula. You know, 2pr by 100. That was 550. That was simple interest was 550. I guess simple interest was 550. So my principal is A. So 2A only I want. R is 20 divided by 100 is equal to 550. 25. So 2A I want. So this is 2750. This is the value of 2A. That would be 2A. 2750. Simple. So I hope you enjoyed these questions. So this much what I thought to teach you for simple interest and compound interest. The thing what you need to understand here while solving the problem on simple interest and compound interest, that this is the formula what we normally use for compound interest. This is the formula you can use. Instead of doing this formula, you can use the successive percentage also. Like if my principal is 500 rupees, and my rate is 10%, and the time is 3 years. So if I ask you what is the amount I'm getting, so you can use this formula that amount is equal to 500 into 1 plus 10 by 100 to the power 3. You can use this formula, 500, this is 11 by 10 to the power 3. So you can solve this. This is 500 into, this is 1331 divided by 1000. This is pizza. Then this is 665.5. So this much your money will become like this. You can solve, or you can solve it like this. 500, you're getting 10%. 10% of this is 50, so it become 550. So again 10% of that. So 10%, that is 55. So 55 means it becomes 605. Then again 10% of that. So 10% of this is 60.5. So 60.5 means this will become 665.5. You can do like this way, or you can do like this way. Both will give you the same sense. So I hope you understand. If I, the same question, if I ask you what is the interest, what is the interest earned? So that is 50 plus 55 plus 60.5. So I can do that. So 50 threes are 150. 150 plus 5, 155. Then 155. So 150 and then how much more than 150? This is 5 more than 150. This is 10.5 more than 150. 150 plus 15.5. So 150, 165.5. So the total interest he earned is 165.5. You can do like this, or here if you can use the formula for this. Here also you can use the formula for that. That is 1.1 to the power 3 minus 1. If you do, you will get the same answer, 165.5. So it's all up to you. The way you want to do, you can solve it. It doesn't matter how you want to solve it. So solve it in any way. So you can solve it, you get the same answer. So 500 is 31,000. Anyway, that is 331 by 2 is 165.5. So it's all up to you. I prefer to solve like this way. I believe this way I can do much more faster. So that's why I avoid using formula. Again, it's your way, the way you want to connect the dots. You can connect the dot by your own way. Ultimately, the thing which is important for us is to get the answer. Whatever way you get the answer, everything is justified. In maths, ultimately, your speed should be good. Because in quantitative aptitude exam, the thing what matters is that how fast you can do. So it's better for all of us to develop on our speed calculation, how fast we can do. So I hope you enjoyed this session. So with that intention, I'd like to say goodbye to all of you. Thank you, everyone. God bless you. Bye. So again, please don't forget to like the session. Click on the like button and please subscribe to my channel if you are not subscribed. Thank you.